I'll just start with a small introduction. I am Archika Jain. I am the founder of the Silent Door, Unleash Your Mind. This is a platform for mental health and psychological services. It provides counseling, various workshops, training programs, coaching classes, and internships. And today we have Sharda Ji with us, Sharda Chakrabarty. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, Archita, for a warm welcome. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Yes. So, Mrs. Sharda Chakrabarty, she is a certified career counselor and she's an entrepreneur by heart, a motivational speaker by hobby. She is actually the founder of a Golden Future Career in Counseling. She's a teacher as well, and she has coached many people, many students, and she has been guiding people for years. And through her knowledge, today we'll have a lot of things to know about. And today's topic is secrets to excel in board exams. So, ma'am, can we start with the session?
Yes, of course.
I have a short introduction from you only about yourself.
Okay. As told by Archika, she has very well explained. I was a teacher. For last 20 years, I'm teaching. I joined when I was, 21 years old. I started my career as a teacher. Then, suddenly this lockdown brought so many opportunities for me. And when I was going for my daughter's career counseling, I found that the people, the counselors, they're asking, about 10,000, somebody 15,000. So I thought this particular area where the students, they can't even afford, why should I not become a certified career counselor and do my little help or drop, just extend my help to these students. And as I was teaching class 9, 10, 11, 12, basically the senior section, and I found them very confusing, actually. So now this particular period got me a very, very, this, I think it was a golden time for me. I got to know many things. I did personality development, public speaking, then memory enhancement. And I'm now helping the students with these, all these things. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much for guiding us, and for you are here for these students who are very much confused, and we know how is the situation, that exams have been delayed, people students were not able to study during this lockdown, and because they were at home, they were facing a lot of problems, they were not getting that formal environment in which they can study. So they are facing a lot of problems academically, emotionally, psychologically, a lot of problems. So please guide them so that they can know how to utilize their time in utilize their short time and get excel in the exams. So ma'am, please.
Sure. First of all, this is going to be a very casual conversation.
Exactly.
Actually, last year, what happened, I was coaching few students. They were in class 10. Usually, I don't teach after January. I usually give them February so that they can study themselves.
So,
but these students, they came, their parents, they started calling me up, ma'am, please teach them in month of February also. So I said, okay, I called them. Then I asked, what is your root problem? What is the problem? What are you getting scared of? So they said, ma'am, we can't sleep at night. I said, okay, what happened? They said, ma'am, when we are studying, we are thinking that there is so much of syllabus to complete, and how am I, we are going to pass in the exam. It's very difficult for us to pass also. So I said, okay, wait. And these tips, I always give it to all my students. So what I did, I took their, this was in the 1st of February, and I took their books. I asked them, I took a paper and I asked them, please write down how many chapters you have in geography, how many chapters in history, how many chapters in civics, and so on. And now you are going to study two subjects every day apart from maths. Maths, it's regular. Maths you have to do regularly. And then I made it, what I did, For example, 1st February, History, Chapter Number 1, English, Chapter Number 1. Then second one, suppose Geography, Chapter Number 1, and in this way. And now 3rd February, History, 1st Chapter, Revision, and History, 2nd Chapter, up till this much part. Whatever, like they told me, ki, ma'am, I can study till here. But in this way, what happened, you know, you must have seen, the students must have seen, when the teachers come in the class, they don't need books. They don't need books.
Exactly.
Why they don't need books? Because a teacher, when I was a teacher, first year, it was very difficult for me. I was struggling. I had to take my books. I used to study from my books because teaching 9, 10, 11, 12 is not easy. So every time I used to go from class to class with the books. And then, you know, second year, I was very, very little comfortable. And now, I don't need books. I don't need books. I don't even see the book. Yes, but I keep on checking the new events happening in the our biology, because I'm a biology teacher, so I keep on finding it out. I don't need book. So how it happened? By repetitions. This is called repetitions. I have repeated a thing so many times, but you don't have that much of year, you know, 20 years to spend here. So what you can do, you can just, like when you start a fresh thing, revise the previous one and then go to the next one. Then the next one, suppose A you have revised, then go with the, you are doing B. And on the next day, when you are taking again history, then you just, you know, do the revision of B and then go to C. Because revision will hardly take a few, not more than half an hour. Now, being a school teacher, I will tell you some tips and techniques. How will you excel in your board exams? My students who were struggling to get 80% also, and you will be surprised, they got 91%. 91%, and they were also surprised. So I told them what to do. So I'm sharing these tips, and I'm 101% sure that you will also be benefited with these tips. The first thing, many students, you know, they have, their teachers keep on complaining. Do you know, your writing is very bad. Your writing is very poor. Please improve your writing. But no one tells how to improve, because in class 10 and 12, you don't know how to improve. So what you are going to do, just leave one finger gap. Pehla, you know, you'll have some problem ki one finger gap. You'll have to put your left hand if you're a right hander, and then, you know, gapping. But after some time, it will, you know, your eyes will be suited. For example, when you don't know any spelling, you write it twice. For example, APPLE, then you write APLE. Your eyes will tell you which particular spelling is correct. Your eyes will judge. Similarly, after 2-3 days, you know, you will have this gap, this gapping, and your writing will look neat. When everything is very neatly placed, what is the aim of teacher? Teacher wants that work is neat so that she can easily check. Second thing. Yes?
No.
Okay. The next thing, every time, you must have heard your parents telling you, "Arey boards exam mein aayega, pata chalega. Boards ko aane do. Boards mein jaake pata chalega, kuch bhi nahi kar paoge." And teachers and parents, they have made this, you know, boards like a hawa. Like they, it's in the back of the mind, they are always tense. Kya hoga boards mein? But let me tell you one very secret tips with you. In the school, the teachers are biased. I'm being a teacher, I'm telling you, we are biased. How? Because when we are checking the copies, we want to ease our work. What we do, we take out the best 4 or 5 copies.
Yeah.
The students who are scoring 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th number in the school class. So we take out. And then we start checking. And now we know each and every answer also. And we have a set parameter. Okay, I have given 4.5 marks to this child. I will not give more than 4.5 to this child. But in boards, no one knows you. Who is there to judge you? The teachers are stranger. And, you know, you'll be so very comfortable. And my students became very comfortable. Arey, ma'am, ye to sach mein, they don't know us. Wo to humko kaise judge karegi ki hum average student hai, ki hum ek good student hai, or intelligent hai. So, you know, and this pressure, when it went out, and they were, you know, school mein, they were just average, you know, 75% to 80%. And in boards, they got 91%. So they said, ma'am, your this particular point just released our all the stress. So she's a stranger, वो तो serial में copy check करेगी. Serial में कोई भी आए तो वो उसको check करेगी, उसको नहीं पता. She doesn't know what type of child this is. So this is a very, very good advantage. Stranger है, stranger को तो impress आप कर सकते only in 3 hours. And school teachers, they know you right from the junior class to the senior class. So it is very, very difficult to impress them once your impression goes wrong. And again in the school, you know what happens? This, you know, the average student, by chance, उसको अच्छा marks मिल गया, अच्छा उसने answer दे दिया. He learned 5 questions and answers, and that came in the exam by luck. And now when teacher sees, you know, he, this average student has written so good answer. Must have cheated, and in the back of her mind, she will not give her good marks. She will not give her good marks because she knows he, this boy has or girl has cheated. So this is not going to happen in the board exams.
This biasness comes automatically.
Yes, it comes.
I have also been a teacher, so it automatically comes. Because we start judging, this judgment part always interferes in marking the students. Right.
Yes, absolutely, Archita. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So I'm telling you the tip because every teacher, you know, they don't discuss. But I just want you to be, you know, very free and give your exam bang on. And I'm telling you, if you're going to follow these techniques, you're going to excel in your boards. Second thing, next thing you're going to when your presentation. See, when you go to a roadside dhaba, roadside mein koi dukaan hai, and you go and buy chowmin. It will cost you, you know, max to max 15 to 20 rupees. But the same thing, you know, when you keep on increasing the standard of the hotel, restaurants, like if you go to much better, so it will cost you about 150 to 200. If you go more than that, it will be 4 to 500. Why? The same chowmin made up of maida, made up of vegetables, all those vegetables, sauces and all, everything. Why? Why they are charging you 500, 600? Anyone? Can you tell me why do you pay so much when you go to a good restaurant or a 5-star hotel? You pay so much because of presentation. The presentation is so good. Yes. Yes, of course. The presentation is so good. And you don't hesitate to give the more money. Similarly, if your presentation is good, the teacher will be very, very impressed. And how you will improve your presentation? By leaving one finger gap between two words, your work will look neat. And after every answer, leave 3 lines. Mm-hmm. Leave 3 lines. Because the teacher will understand now the next question is starting. Mm-hmm. And one more advantage. During revision, if you think I've slipped this particular point, you can write in that gap. You can write that point in that gap, in that 3 line. So then what will happen? Your work will also not look clumsy. It will look very neat. And there is no need to use a ruler and scale like class 1 or 3 students. No, don't do that. Leave 3-line gap. And when the bigger sections, you know, 5 marks questions and all, when they are used, started from the next page, fresh page, always. Okay, 1 mark, 2 marks, you can do it. But a big question like 5 marks, last section. You try to take it from a new page. So it will, your work will look very, very clear. Now, next thing. When your friend gives you a storybook or a book you want from him, so what do you, sometimes he has highlighted, he has put some underline. Where your eyes goes? In that underline part, you just see that underline part and you see what is that particular words which he has or she has underlined. Similarly, the teacher are looking, I'm a CBSE teacher, the teachers are looking for those keywords. Mm-hmm. And if your answer is highlighted, she will immediately see that she will get those few words which she wants in that particular answer and she will give you the full marks. Mm-hmm. And in this way, you can easily impress your teacher.
Exactly.
And the next one, try to answer point-wise. Just try to answer point-wise. When your answers are point-wise, the teachers become very impressed because she knows that this particular child is very confident because a confident child will always writing points. And if you're writing in paragraph, just underline the important words.
Yes.
Is it clear to everyone? Have you understood how these techniques will help you? Okay. How many students are scared of maths? Maths is a, you know, very, very scary subject. I sometimes see, you know, the students, because I go for CBSE board duties, I find the students, you know, crying after the maths exam. Yes, what happened? Ma'am, I knew these questions, but I was not able to complete the questions. I could not attempt. Mm-hmm. Have you, it has happened with you also?
Yes, you can all answer. You can turn videos and answer. You can just answer if you are facing any problem. Okay?
Okay. So you can unmute if you face this problem of like maths, you know, you like sometimes it happened with you also. कि मैथ्स में अच्छा नहीं हुआ, एग्जाम नहीं कर पाए, क्वेश्चन आता हुआ नहीं कर पाए. नाउ आई विल गिव यू वेरी वेरी गुड टिप्स ऑन दिस. हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स वांट टिप्स ऑन हाउ टू एक्सेल इन मैथ्स एग्जाम? हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स वांट? आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ अस, बिकॉज एज व्हेन आई वाज अ स्टूडेंट नोबडी टोल्ड मी. सो आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर दिस सीक्रेट विद यू. द सीक्रेट इज दैट यू नो in CBSE we have part marking means a part marking step wise. If you have written the steps, you will get full marks for the steps, and if your answer is wrong, -1. If your answer is wrong but the steps are correct, though, you will get -1. If it is 5 marks question, you will get 4. Understood? Now many students, what they do, you know, they keep on doing the answer, correct, so many calculations, and at the end they don't know whether the answer is correct or not. So what you will do till the last step and stop where there is a lot of calculation. Stop there. Because if your answer is wrong, then also you will get -1. If your steps are missing, then also you will get -1. So isn't it a very good idea? And proceed to the next question and keep on doing. Now you will see in your watch, it is half an hour. You have got half an hour time. Come back and do those questions. Now at the back of your mind, you know, my all questions are done. And in each question, if I say -1, so max to max, I will get -5, means out of 80 marks, or I think 90 marks in boards. Like here we have 80 marks in class 12. So what will happen? So here only -5, because your steps are correct, your calculations are not done. If your calculations are not done, still you will get marks for the for this steps. So isn't it a good idea?
Yes.
So nobody shared this idea with me, but whenever I shared this idea, the students, they really catch it, you know, and they say ki ma'am, it was a Ramban, means you have helped us, and at in the last we were able to complete all our questions, all our
exactly. Sharda ji, because I have personally seen people leaving whole questions, they didn't try the question, they didn't even try. They can, in math especially, they can write the statements or anything which they know, even they can write the formula or the starting of the answer, what we have to comprehend. They may face problem in calculations, but at least they have to try.
Yes.
Help them in scoring some marks. Yes.
Yes, absolutely correct.
Yeah.
And now physics. Physics is another, you know, problematic. Same here. Like, for example, the question comes on kinetic energy. For example, you don't know how to do that. Write the, you know, you have forgotten the definition. Never mind. Because the examiner who is sitting there, they want your concept. Give with the help of example, like the moving arrow or the flowing water. Write the formula. Write the SI unit if you don't know how to do it. Because teacher will give you, instead of zero, she will give you some marks there. And आपको तो वैसे ही माइनस करके रखा था आपने उसमें, लेकिन आपको इसकी वजह से यू कैन गेट मार्क्स. सो दीज आर द फ्यू थिंग्स व्हिच आई थिंक द स्टूडेंट्स, इफ दे नो, दे विल score above 90%.
Very good tips. Yes.
Did you find it interesting, students who are sitting there here?
Yes, you can reply in chat box or you can unmute yourself and then reply. Yes.
Okay, Aryan, thank you so much. See, the students, abhi, apko, you know, bahut sara, you know, they will, people will give you this and that. One thing more. Never, ever discuss before the exam.
Yes.
Never, ever discuss. If somebody is confused, he or she will make you confused. Mm-hmm. You go to one corner, never discuss. Because your preparation is done, you are fully done. And there is no place to take anybody's suggestions now.
Yes.
Because
yes.
If you take their suggestion, you will get confused.
Hmm.
और सबसे ज्यादा बच्चे confused होते हैं examination hall में जाने से पहले. एक confused बच्चा, अच्छा बता बता इसका answer.
Hmm.
ये होगा ना? When they give you the option, you also get confused.
Yes.
So don't
study this and he's saying this. So
हाँ.
में सारा ना mix up हो जाता है और ज्यादा
confused. Yes, yes.
And after exam also, I have seen people discussing the question paper. What is it?
Yeah.
And it impacts their next exam.
Yes, yes.
So not be done. But I yes. think this should also not be done. They should not discuss after the exam. Yes, they can have casual discussion over the answers or over overall like paper and exam. But should not discuss in detail because it actually impacts their next exam. They feel
absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
This needs to be taken care of.
Yes. And I think today you must have learned many new tips. You know, these are not discussed anywhere. Being a teacher for so long, I can tell you because I used to go for class 10 corrections. Now I go for 12 CBSE corrections. I also go for my for copy corrections. I go for practical take as a examiner, external examiner, and I am also doing resourcing in many ways. So in this way, I know.
That's great. So that's great. Please take advantage of this. And I would just want you to know. Yes, Shardaji, I just want to ask you, there is one more problem with students. They find it very difficult to retain a lot of subject matter. So what is your idea or what are your tips to help them to retain more and more? Because we don't have time. Students don't have time. So how can they retain more with more concentration? I have seen that people are, like students are facing a lot of concentration issues as well. So...
Okay, now I will tell you a very, very good technique. This technique is, you know, sometimes you must have seen that what happens, you know, in a particular answer, there is many words which are very insignificant. For example, there was, is, all these things. And in that 50 word answer, there are max to max only 7 to 8 words important, the keywords.
Yes.
So when you just go and just skip, because you know our mind gets very, very puzzled when we see such a big answer. We get very, very puzzled. This is our problem. Even if like somebody gives me a long paragraph, first of all, my brain, you know, stops working. It's na bada padhna hai, so long.
Mm.
So now what you can do, that you are going to take the keywords, just underline them. Just, and in like if you're a CBSE student or any board, like I know about CBSE. In CBSE, there is in our CBSE board, there is a cbse.nic.in where you will get the question paper and the answer also. So there if you download both the question and the answer, you will understand there are only few keywords which are mentioned there. Because teacher, they need that keywords. And if you, in this way, if you download both the sample paper and their answers, it is there in the cbse.nic.in. And you can easily get the sample paper and the question paper and the answer. and just see that only they have written the keywords, and the teacher is also looking for keywords. So whatever book you are following, like for example NCERT, they have lovely books. Don't write beyond that. See, in Indian system, we don't have any place to show our this how intelligent we are. How well we can write is most important. A child may not be very expressive in the class, but if he writes well, na, he will get marks. So it is your presentation. तो आपको आपने पढ़ लिया गूगल से इधर से उधर से इधर से लिखने बैठे, अब टीचर क्या करेगी? हम लोग को बोर्ड से वी गेट यू नो फुल ब्लूप्रिंट, टीचर हैज गॉट दोस 10 कीवर्ड्स, शी इज लुकिंग फॉर दोस 10 कीवर्ड्स, एंड नाउ दिस चाइल्ड हैज रिटन 15 कीवर्ड्स फ्रॉम समवेयर इन द गूगल, शी हैज टू सर्च एंड शी इज गेटिंग इरिटेटेड, एंड दिस इंपैक्ट्स इन द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. दिस गिव्स because and one thing I want to tell you students, that class in our system, teacher's marks, jisne agar teacher ne 4.5 de diya 5 se, it cannot be even challenged in the supreme court pe bhi aap challenge nahi kar sakte ho teacher ne aapko kitna marks diya hai. ha agar galat de diya hai, aapne likha hai apple aur usne kaat diya, वहां पे आंसर और कुछ और वहां पे एप्पल ही आंसर था, लेकिन उसने उन्होंने काट दिया, देन ओके. बट इफ शी हैज रिटन गिवन एन आंसर गिवन 4.5 फॉर योर करेक्ट आंसर, इवन बोर इन इवन द सुप्रीम कोर्ट कैन नॉट चैलेंज. सो आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग? डोंट इरिटेट योर टीचर्स, बिकॉज इफ शी गेट्स इरिटेटेड शी विल दैट इम्पैक्ट इन द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन आंसर्स.
यस, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट.
Anything they want to ask something?
Yeah, Sharadaji, actually I just wanted to know, how can they retain more in less time?
Retain more, that is only I have told you in the beginning, they have to go through that keywords. They will know. See, what I do, I ask my students that sticky notes, you know, the sticky notes they come, they can put a few important words from that particular answers. For example, if I say, like I'm a science teacher, like for example stomata, if the function of stomata comes, so only there are two keywords, okay. That is transpiration and exchange of gases,
okay,
these are the two keywords.
Yes.
But for these two keywords they have to write 50 words.
Yes, and if these two words are missing, you will not get marks.
Yes, they will not get marks,
because they, yes, students think that we'll write the stories and we'll get marks. If they it is of 50 words, we'll write 50 words somehow and we'll get marks. But this won't be happen. Yes, we need to note down this does not happen. You need to write those keywords, just focus on those keywords. This is very important thing which Sharadaji has told, and everybody should keep this in mind. This is an important thing to get more marks. A very important point to get more marks. Yes. So Ananya, do you want to ask anything?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Good evening, ma'am.
Very good.
Ma'am, I have to ask that. Ma'am, during board, we usually have less concentration in our studies. Ma'am, how to improve that?
Yes.
Very good.
Less concentration. You know why the students has less concentration? Because they don't have the habit to sit 3 hours. We don't sit 3 hours at a stretch in our house also. Okay. For example, like, you know, if you are studying one page, just, you know, do this exercise today. And I told my students to do this exercise. It was very, very useful. I said, there is no need. कोई आपको फांसी भी नहीं देगा. आप टाइम देख लो, मैं कितने बजे से, मैं 10 बजे पढ़ने बैठी हूँ, एंड देन यू नोट डाउन 10:15 तक मैंने पढ़ा, देन आई वेंट टू ड्रिंक अ ग्लास ऑफ वाटर, फिर आप कितने बजे वापस आए हो, जस्ट नोट इट डाउन, देन अगेन यू विल गो समथिंग टू ईट, और यू विल गो फॉर वॉशरूम, और यू विल गो सम लुकिंग आउटसाइड द विंडो. तो वेन यू विल सी ना दैट हाउ मच टाइम यू आर वेस्टिंग, इट विल बिकम डिफिकल्ट. नाउ फॉर एग्जाम्पल योर बोर्ड एग्जाम्स, यू नो, yesterday one person whom I know, she has, you know, done clear, means gave her gate IIT Bombay, And she told all of us, he liked the exam was very easy, though it was very difficult. So how she did it, you know, for last 7 days, what she did, she sat in the same timing in which she will give exam. For example, the board's timing is 10 to 1 for example, CBSE. So 10 to 1, she used to sit every day, 7 days before the exam. Same timing. She did it.
Very helpful.
Okay. Yes. And then she did, you know what, actually I'm doing law of attraction practice also. Exactly. In law of attraction, you know, because we are all made up of energy, so we can attract energy. Mm-hmm. How? By affirmations. Mm-hmm. What are these affirmations? Like, you will think that you have given your board exams. Like, I have given my board exams. I have learned very easily and very happily. I'm studying and I have given the exam. I have scored 95%. Like this, you know, if you're going to do this, it looks very foolish. But I have seen the cases, you know, this law of attraction, and she gave her testimony yesterday in the same group. We are in one group. So she said, first of all, she went and she did this thing. Cleaned the place. Jahan pe exam degi, it was online exam. So she cleaned the computer. She cleaned her pen, her place. And then she was giving this 7 days before she was giving the exam. So the mindset was, you know, set that I'm giving in this particular time. And the exam was very, very good. So these are the things, you know, you have to maintain concentration and always remember, you have worked so hard for last 365 days, you are working hard. And this year, your syllabus is less. In the next year, the syllabus will be more. And in the last year, the syllabus was more. So some, you are blessed that the syllabus is less. So you have to take bang on advantage, because these 3 hours, only for 3 hours, you have worked hard for last 365 days and more than that.
Mm-hmm.
And you have done, you know, because nobody is going for failure. Everybody wants success.
Yes.
So you also want success. So if you keep, if dekho, agar purpose bahut strong hai na, you will reach. Bachpan mein dekha hoga, mummy kahin par bhi kuch chupa ke rakhti thi, to aap uspe, uske upar, ek chair ke upar, phir uske upar kabhi bhai ko ghoda bana ke, you used to take it out. Because your purpose was your very strong. Mm-hmm. So you know, you have to think that this one is very strong and I have to reach here.
Yes.
I have to do it. और कभी कभी जब आपको घूमने जाना होता है, मम्मी पापा से परमिशन कैसे ले लेते हो? कैसे गुड गर्ल गुड बॉय बन जाते हो? बिकॉज यू वॉन्ट कि आपको मम्मी पापा को भी बड़ा आश्चर्य होता है, एक बार बुला रहे हैं तो दिस चाइल्ड इज कमिंग, तो दे बिकम यू नो सो सॉफ्ट. एंड देन यू टेल, आई हैव अ पार्टी विद माई फ्रेंड, आई वॉन्ट टू गो. सो यू कैन डू इट, यू कैन डू इट वट एवर यू वॉन्ट.
यस, डेफिनेटली. Very, very good. Malam, you need to be motivated to improve your concentration.
Yes.
Motivation is very important. And I will just add one thing. Just write, what do you want to do? Like, you make some purpose in your life. Ananya and everyone, just write down, what do you want from these board exams? What are your expectations? Just note it down. It will really help you a lot, because hum mind mein kuch bhi karte rehte hain, sochte rehte hain, it does not help. Just note it down. If I get this much of percentage, or I'll study for at least 6 hours a day, just write it down in your notebook. These writing will help you a lot. Actually, I'm a graphologist as well. So these are our writings, are connected to our mind. Whatever we write or whatever we think, we'll write that. So this mind and our writing is very much connected. So just write it down. And you might have heard writing helps a lot. Journaling karte hai na log. So write your purpose. What do you want? How much do you want to show? And why do you want to this? What do you want? Why do you want? How do you want? Just write these three things. This will really help you to make a purpose. And this purpose will motivate you and help you increase your concentration. So what do you want, why do you want, and how do you want? These three, just these three tips which I have added, just try this, maybe you will get your answer and it will help you. It will really help you increase your concentration. So today only, just write it down. We are not able to concentrate and focus. We are not able to retain because we don't have purpose. पढ़े जा रहे हैं, क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं? ठीक है, इंजीनियर बनना है, ये बनना है, वो बनना है. अभी क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं? वो तो बाद में बनेंगे ना. अभी ये बोर्ड्स एग्जाम का क्या मकसद है? What is your motivation of attempting these board exams? So find your motivation, find your purpose of giving these board exams. You will really find it very helpful. This will help you focus in your exams. This will help you in increasing your concentration. And also there are small things which you need to take care of. थोड़ा शांत वाले माहौल में आपको पढ़ना है. जस्ट अपने आप को थोड़ा सा सेपरेट कर लीजिए. डोंट ट्राई टू स्टडी विद एवरीवन. लाइक एवरीवन इज सिटिंग इन द रूम एंड यू आर स्टडिंग. दिस इज नॉट द वे. एंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट, टेक प्रॉपर स्लीप, टेक प्रॉपर डाइट. दीज आर ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इट्स नॉट लाइक हाँ हम तो रात रात भर जग के पढ़ते हैं. इट वॉन्ट हेल्प यू. इट विल रियली रिड्यूस योर कंसेंट्रेशन लेवल. लॉकडाउन में यही हुआ है मैम. लाइक आई विल टेल यू, आई हैव टॉक्ड टू मेनी स्टूडेंट्स. दे आर नॉट स्लीपिंग एट नाइट. दे आर स्लीपिंग लेट एंड दे आर वेकिंग अप लेट. बिकॉज ऑफ देम दे हैव देमसेल्व्स नोटेड दैट देयर कंसंट्रेशन लेवल इज लोअर्ड. इट हैज बीन रिड्यूस्ड. एंड दिस इज द मेजर रीजन विच आई हैव नोटिस्ड एंड आई हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड इन पीपल, इन द स्टूडेंट्स स्पेशली. नॉट ओनली द स्कूल स्टूडेंट्स, द graduation one, the graduation students who are doing graduation, post graduation, every kind of student is facing this problem. So this is very important. What to do, how to do, why to do. Just try this.
And also the students, you know, in this lockdown, they have got this cheating habit, you know, when the books are open, during they are not giving, giving too much of importance. That I know. Yeah. So now, because you have not studied properly for your board exams, so now you have, you know, whatever you have time, make a timetable, you know, just take 3 subjects every day. Yes. 3 subjects, not more than that. Mm-hmm. Relax, I'm telling you, you will get 91% above. And either you have to decide how, like, what do you want. And remember, my dear students, there is no past, there is no future. फ्यूचर में क्या है हमको नहीं पता. इट्स यू नो ब्लाइंड, इट्स बंद है. और पास्ट वी कैन चेंज. सो व्हाट वी कैन चेंज, दिस प्रॉपर मूवमेंट. यू नो देयर वाज अ, आई रिमेम्बर द स्टोरी ऑफ अ पर्सन, यू नो, एक कारपेंटर और एक उसका मालिक. तो कारपेंटर बूढ़ा हो गया था एंड कारपेंटर को अब घर जाना था. तो कारपेंटर टोल्ड हिज मालिक कि सर, आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू वर्क एनी मोर, आई वॉन्ट टू गो होम. तो उसका जो मालिक था वो बहुत रिच था. तो उसने कहा कि मेरा प्लीज एक लास्ट असाइनमेंट कर दो, मेरा एक घर बना दो और उसका फर्नीचर का काम तुम्हें करना है. सारा का सारा जितना भी डोर्स एंड ऑल, तो वो बोला कि तुमको बनाना है. तो उसने कहा ओके. एंड ही वाज नॉट एट ऑल इंटरेस्टेड एंड इट वाज द वर्स्ट वर्क ही डिड, यू नो, माने जल्दी जल्दी. एंड ही वांटेड टू गो. एंड लास्ट डे एक महीना कंप्लीट हो गया एंड ही गेव द कीज टू हिज मालिक एंड ही सेड कि सर, योर आपका घर मैंने बना दिया है. एंड मालिक ने क्या किया, वो चाबी ली और उस कारपेंटर के हाथ में रख दी और बोला, ये घर मैंने तुम्हारे लिए बनवाया था, तुमने मेरी इतनी साल सेवा की तो मैंने ये घर तुम्हारे लिए बनवाया था. अब ये कारपेंटर बोलने का, काश मैं ये अच्छा कर लेता, ये तो मैंने मेरे सबसे जिंदगी का सबसे बुरा काम ये था. तो कभी, यू नो, काश नहीं होना चाहिए कि बाद में कि मैंने ये क्यों नहीं पढ़ा. काश नहीं, प्रेजेंट इज द ट्रुथ. Present is the truth.
Definitely.
Very, you know, we don't know कल सवेरे कितने लोग उठ नहीं पाएंगे. कल कितने लोग नहीं देख पाएंगे. तो how do we know what is stored for us tomorrow or day after tomorrow? But we know the present. You know, make your present beautiful. Your future will be beautiful. Yes. I hope you got the answer, Ananya. If you have any problem, you can surely connect with me. Archika has my Instagram and everything ID.
Yeah.
So you can surely, whenever you have problem, Archika is a great, I have seen her, I have known to her, and she's always very, like, whenever I've interacted with her, she was very soft, and like I keep on, you know, talking and all so much, but she's very calm and composed and very good. This is very good for students. Thank you, Achika.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, I have one more question, that if we are having lots of knowledge about that question, how we can conclude all that points in that question in less words?
See, this is the mistake, you know, once of the students do. Like the 2-mark question. Now, this time, boards may, like in CBSE, I don't know about other 2-mark question, max to max, 3 to 4 lines. Okay, max to max. Now, this child, he knew so much that he wrote everything. At the end, how much he got? 2 marks.
Exactly.
If you know the full Google, you have Googled everything about it and you wrote, you will not get more than 2. Teacher will not think, teacher will get irritated. Why when 4 points are required, why she has written 20 points? So my dear students, this is my request. Please follow your books. Which board are you from, Anaya? Which board are you from? Can you tell me?
CBSE.
Yes, CBSE. I'm teaching. I'm a CBSE teacher. I'm telling you. See, and the word limitations are there. This time there is no 2-mark question in CBSE class 12.
Ma'am, so that's now, why I'm asking this.
Yes, I'm telling you because I'm a CBSE teacher. You're going to stick with the word limit and write only the relevant points which are there in your NCERT book. Because the teachers who have set the paper are from, they only follow NCERT in biology. In chemistry and physics, they can give you questions from outside, but the concept will be from there. Theoretical portion will be from there. Now, what you do, you consult so many reference books and your brain become, you know, puzzled. It is very, very difficult. If you want, I can, if you really want, I can give you, I can help you by giving you some site, you know, from a website, a particular site, which I follow and I tell my students to follow that site. It is very good, the videos, and because it is from CBSE only. So it is to the point. If you are interested, you can tell Archika so that I can help you out with that. I can give you the link so that you can follow and study. Okay, yes. Is it clear?
Yes. Yes, it is very important to just stick to the word limit, because for 2 marks, we have 30 to 40 words generally. So I would just add something like, Anaya, what happens when we have a lot of things? Like, what stream do you have, Anaya? Are you in 10th or 12th?
Ma'am, I am in 11th.
You are in 11th. Okay, yes, fine. Okay, no problem. What in whatever class you have, you might have faced this problem. If it is a 2-mark question, just write to the point what has been asked. If it is a 3-mark question,
you're saying correct.
Yeah. So if it is a 3-mark question, you can add, apart from that to the point answer, add something more that is relevant to the answer. And then if it is 4-marker, then add more related in addition to that to the point answer. To the point answer आपने लिखा, उसके अलावा जो आपको लगता है, ऐसा नहीं करना starting में पहले story से शुरू करना है. I have seen students writing stories in the starting. वो story लिखते लिखते वो conclusion तक पहुंच ही नहीं पाते. Fine. Or examples are must in every answer. Try to give more and more, because you will get a lot of value based questions, application based questions this year. Many, many questions which would be application based. So you should have proper knowledge. You should have proper understanding of what you are studying. Only the notes, only the text in the book is like, only just cramming up will not help you. Try to understand and go in depth, and then write accordingly. And don't forget about the keywords. Am I able to answer your question, Anaya?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Yes. Any other question? Muskan, Kirti Raj, Tanya. If you have any other question, you can ask. You can even ask in the chat box.
Achha, tell me, this was a good, means have you learned many good techniques? And one thing I forgot, if it is your board exam, don't do in the school exam. in CBSE, we have or questions, okay? We have or questions, okay? And sometimes, you know, we do it and then we think whether this or part can fetch me more marks. So you can, in the board exams, do it in the last. Do it in the last, but not in the school exam. Because the school teacher will just roast you.
Yeah.
Because she will find you and she will roast you up. But in the board exams, you can do this. Yes, Anaya.
Ma'am, we have now, according to new CBSE guidelines, we have many multiple choice questions.
How yes, can 20 we deal with yes. It? Yes, I know.
So,
tell yes, me.
Ma'am, I am asking that how can we deal with that multiple questions easily with less study?
No. That is why, you know, this concept has come. Because students were not able to do well in, sometimes they were not able to do good in the competitive exams. Therefore, these questions, you know, assertion and reasoning has also come. Mm-hmm. That whether the AR questions, which we call assertions and reasoning, these questions have come, whether they are your concept is clear or not. See, the most difficult part is, you know, when I check the copies, most of the students, they write those long answers, you know, they are easily right. 3 marks, 5 marks questions, most 2 marks, they are correct. But 1 mark question answers are most of the times wrong. Mm-hmm. Because when for writing big answers, you have, if you even have a vague idea, you can write. But you have this vague idea will not help in the, I'm telling you. So this, if you are not thorough, that is why, you know, the CBSE has come with this particular thing. The child's concept should be very clear. And it is, you know, please, it is my request. Please read NCERT. NCERT should be a Bible, Gita, Quran, whatever your this holy books are. They are your holy books in NCERT. And do you know, NCERT books are followed in UPSC exams, IAS and all. So yes. That particular board, that standard is using NCERT books. And I don't understand our poor students, they are overloaded with reference books. Mm-hmm. Overloaded with reference books. They become so confused because reference book, see, your first aim is to gain good mark, get good marks in class, clear class 11, then class 12. Then your competitive exams, you know. Achha, tell me what is the success rate of Akash and all? The success rate, if I say it, is not even 10% also. 10%. And do you know, there are so many careers which just, you know, have a go to a career counselor. She will tell you. I have got 2 students, you know, with me. They came very late. And one of the student was an engineer. He's an engineer. And now he has shifted, you know, just like the 3 idiots. What was his name? I'm forgetting. Farhan. Who went for that photography. He's an engineer and he left his engineering job. He was getting a good income also, but he left it. The second one, I have got one person, he's an engineer and now he has become a DJ. This particular thing, engineering does not make them happy because their skills are not according to them. That is the main thing. And you, all of us, we are having a herd mentality. Herd mane, jahan pe sab ja rahe, humko bhi wahi jana hai.
Yes.
Arre, agar sab yellow kapra pehen ke rakhe hain aur tumne wahan pe pink pehna hai, to tum kitne alag lagoge, kitne pyare lagoge, sab tumko dekhenge. Aur hum log kya sochte hain ki humko sab log dekh rahe hain, oh my God, we feel very shy. No. When somebody looks at you, you feel proud that I'm different from them. So do something which is different. And do you know, by 2030 or at 32, there will be many jobs which will be no more in existence because artificial intelligence is coming. A doctor, 1,000 logon ka operation kar sakta hai. Okay, there was one more question by somebody. Actually, I'm not sitting on my laptop.
No. I'll just tell you. It's from Kirti Raj. He said, ki, ma'am, sometimes in haste, we forget some answers. What can be done to recollect it? You forget to write, Kirti Raj? You forget to write the answers?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, yes, ma'am.
Okay, you know, maybe it will seem a very foolish idea to you, but I really tell it to my students also, and I'm telling to you. जो एक तुलसी का पत्ता होता है ना, तुलसी का पत्ता, तुलसी पत्ता, उसको धोकर अपने साथ लेके जाओ इन द एग्जामिनेशन हॉल, और उसको अपने टंग के नीचे रखो. डोंट बाइट इट, डोंट कट इट विद योर टीथ.
यस, आई हैव आल्सो हर्ड
दैट. वहीं पे रहने दो,
वहीं
पे रहने दो. हाँ, और आपको मालूम है, आपने शायद एक क्वेश्चन एग्जाम से पहले नहीं पढ़ा उसका आंसर, और आपने उसको एक महीना पहले पढ़ा था, अच्छे से पढ़ा था. एंड डू यू नो, यू विल रिमेम्बर, यू विल रिमेम्बर इट. एंड दिस इज अ प्रूवन मेथड, प्रूवन एंड टेस्टेड एंड प्रूवन, टेस्टेड, ट्राइड एंड प्रूवन. सो दिस इज अ थिंग, यू नो, नाउ एवरी टाइम, यू नो, एंड ऑल्सो इट इंक्रीजेस योर कंसेंट्रेशन. घर में भी आप जब पढ़ रहे हैं ना, तो जस्ट पुट इट इनसाइड योर टंग एंड स्टार्ट. And after the your studies are over, just drink it with water and swallow it. Don't cut it. So I have seen, you know, it is the students, they told me, ma'am, this one, you're small. Maybe somebody told to me, and I also used to, I forgot this thing. But you know, when telling my student, I told them, and they said, ma'am, it really helped us out. And they are doing for last, you know, someone, they are in either in engineering colleges, or they are in doing medical, and they say still they write me. Yes. They are getting so, doing so well for any competitive exams or any scholarships.
Yes,
they do. So you please
incidentally cut it.
Anaya,
ma'am, we incidentally cut that leave.
Never
what
mind.
We have to do.
Nothing you have to do. And first time, see, then you because you know you won't do it. I know, because mere jo bacche hain na, unhone bola ki kisi ne bhi dant se kaata nahi, kyunki back of the mind, kyunki hum log ke according to Hindu mythology hum log bolte hain ki tulsi ko dant se nahi kaatna chahiye. Ek hai ye hum log ke usme, to wo kya hota hai na, wo ek back of the mind mein rehta hai, nahi karte hain bacche, and their concentration, you know, and they told me, ma'am, really. And I'm telling you, these small tips and techniques which I have told you today, nobody is going to tell you. And those who have attended, maybe universe wanted you to come here, because Archika ma'am tried it for many students. But those who have not come, universe did not want them to take this knowledge. The student, and you just, you know, thank universe, because maybe you came here and you have come with so many tips and techniques which you are going to apply. And I'm telling you, at least 5% ka difference aapke marks mein aayega hi aayega.
Yes, exactly. And apart from that, na, you can just tick the answer, tick the questions on the question paper, whatever you have attempted. Like you have attempted fourth question, just put a tick on the question number four on the question paper. And then after that, if you have attempted, you have skipped 5 and then skipped 6th, and you have attempted 7, just put a tick on the question paper, right, Kirti Raj? It will help you a lot. Then you will get to know that which are attempted and which are left. Am I able to answer your question? And Sharda ji has already told you about the about a solution from Hindu mythology.
Yeah.
Fine, Kirti Raj. Do
yes,
you want?
Yes, ma'am. Nothing else.
Okay. Thank you so much. So, any other question do you have from Sharda ji or from me?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So, Sharda ji, do you have anything to address to the students?
I just...
Yes, yes. I don't ask anything.
Ma'am, I want to ask that how can we be our IAS?
How can we... Voice broke up, Anaya.
Ma'am, how can we get our profession of IAS?
IAS.
Or IPS.
Okay. Yes, Sharda ji.
For IAS and all, you know, our NCERT books are of great help.
Yes.
Most of the questions, they are asked from that level. And of course, for that, Anaya, you can, many students, they go for like after, if you have heard about An Academy, Anacademy, Roman Seni, if you know his name, An Academy was made by Roman Saini. He was a doctor and one of the youngest doctor. He's from Rajasthan. So Roman Saini, you know, was a very studious child, and he studied, he gave this, he got medical in one chance, and then he went for IAS, UPSC exam, which is the most difficult exam in India.
Mm-hmm.
And he gave and he cleared that exam also after MBBS. And then when he went for his, training. Yes, when he went for his training, you know, what happened? He did not like it somehow. Usko IAS banta, he was on the top. And then he dropped and he came back to his MBBS medical, and he started his An Academy to help the IAS students to prepare for IAS exams. So if you follow An Academy, it is one of the best. And I think I have told about this to my students about 7 years back. I used to tell them and discuss them when An Academy was not even known by people. An Academy, nobody knew. Now An Academy has fixed a price also. They have now they have made it paid. And at that time it was free. But there are many free things also. You can go there, and mostly our students from humanities background, they get to know or get means more in IAS, because in IAS, UPSC, there is a, you know, general knowledge. In general knowledge, you have to study about history, civics, geography, political science and all. But humanities students, they are studying this as their subject also. But as science students ka bhi hota hai, after they go for medical and they go for engineering, then it becomes easy for them. They have quota. But when you go from general line, it is, of course, it is not an alien thing. If you are going to take coaching and all, so then you are, of course, you are going to make it, because there are nobody alien coming out from here. IIM may be kaun admit hota hai, hum log hi to hote hain, hamare hi to students hote hain. So aisa kuch nahi ki tumhara, bas ha ek dhun honi chahiye social media ki. Abhi maine dekha tha sometimes back, you know, the one who got cleared this IAS exam, he used social media as the weapon. Usne pura ka pura Google se sab kuch, because he was not very rich, to usne yahi se padha and he got it, and he was the first generation learner. उसकी जनरेशन में कोई पढ़ाई भी नहीं किया था. तो अगर धुन का पक्का हो, जो करो कमाल का करो. अगर ये मन में धुन है कि जो करेंगे कमाल का करेंगे, तो आपको कोई नहीं रोक सकता. अगर आपकी धुन है कि मुझे ये लेके पढ़ना है, तो आप जरूर करोगे. एंड ऑल माई बेस्ट विशेस आर देयर. इफ यू हैव एनी थिंग यू वॉन्ट टू आस्क, अचिका मैम इज देयर. यू कैन कनेक्ट विद मी थ्रू माई इंस्टा, through my LinkedIn mein to abhi hoge nahi. You can connect with me through Insta and you can direct message me.
Yeah.
Okay?
You can ask any your Sharda ji's number if you want. If you want to connect personally to her, then you can ask her number from me. Okay?
Okay.
Fine. So let's finish up. Thank you, ji. Thank you, Sharda ji. It was really a very thought-provoking and insightful session. It will really help students to know the secrets, how to excel in board exams. And they were the like proper tips which every student should know. So through this enlightening knowledge of yours, every student would be able to know these tips, and this will really help them to get more and more marks in exams, particularly this year, because this year has been a very challenging year for these students. So thank you so much for your time, for your energy, for your efforts in guiding these students. Thank you everyone for joining.
Thank you. Thank you so much, and all the best for your career. Okay. And your job. Bye-bye.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye.